Hey Cypher Ninjas, it's Martina here to talk to you today about sun salutations. Sun salutations are a very simple yoga practice that you can use and execute anywhere in your day. I'm going to run through some sun salutations this morning. I'm just in my bedroom. I have my jammies on and no shoes. So I don't even have my yoga mat with me, and I don't need one because I can imagine the space that I need, and it's really just the length of my own body that I'll need for this movement. And I'll talk to you a little bit about why sun salutations are so beneficial. Not only do as you move, you're moving with your breath, and you're circulating new blood flow into your system, and you're detoxing at the same time by flushing your lymphatic system. In addition, you're strengthening and toning your muscles, so your muscles are lengthening as they stretch and then contracting in the movements at the same time. And the movement connected with your breath really allows for clarity of mind and rejuvenation of the body at the same time. So it's a really great practice and easy to do. I will demo a few different variations of the movements, and so we'll get started right now. So you're going to come to a standing position to start. This is called Tadasana or Mountain Pose. Your feet are about hips distance apart. Palms are facing out towards the side, so your shoulders are dropping back and down. Your chest is lifted and the crown of your head is lifted. You can close your eyes here, just momentarily connecting to your breath. Take a big inhale through your nose. Then exhale, sigh it out. Next inhale, sweep your arms up and overhead. You can gaze up to your fingertips. Exhale, hands come through heart center. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, hands back through heart center, folding forward. And I'll turn to the side here so you can see that I'm not folding in very far. My knees are bending, my hamstrings are a little tight. I'm just releasing my head down and letting my low back release. I can traction my back a little bit more by clasping my hands on opposite elbows and letting myself sway side to side. This is part of the warm-up. And then release my hands down. Inhale, flat back, long spine, shoulders back. Exhale, fold forward, plant my hands. Step back, find a plank. And then lower to your knees, untuck your toes, and exhale, squeeze your elbows to your ribcage, lower all the way down to your belly. Hands come by your sides, right at your ribcage. Inhale, lift your heart, squeeze your elbows to your spine, gaze forward, low cobra. Exhale, drop back to your knees, press yourself up using the strength of your core, tuck your back toes, come into downward facing dog. So you can see here, I'll move a little bit farther back. You can see here that my hips are high, my head is dropped between my arms for down dog. Heels are yearning towards the mat, but never quite touching. You can pedal out your legs a little bit here. And then moving through the sun salutations as a flow, you'll inhale, look between your hands, bend your knees, and then just step yourself forward. Fold forward. Exhale. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, sweep your arms up and overhead, gaze up. Exhale, hands find your heart. Inhale, arms reach. Exhale, fold forward. Uttanasana is that pose. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step yourself back, find your plank. And maybe a second option, rather than dropping to your knees, is to just lower through what's called chaturanga, which is a half push-up. So elbows in, as opposed to going wide, elbows in towards your rib cage. On your exhale, and then flip your toes under. Inhale, lift your heart. Your legs are lifted off the mat. This is up dog. Exhale, hips go high, downward facing dog. And then one breath in your down dog. Just pause. Next, inhale, look between your hands. Bend your knees. Step yourself forward. Forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, arms reach high. Exhale, hands find your heart. Inhale, sweep your arms high. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands. Find your plank. Option to You lower to your knees again, or stay in your push-up. I'm going to lower to my knees, untuck my toes, and actually just draw my chest to the floor. So this is a three-pointed chaturanga. And then sweep your chest through for up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now I'm not going to cue the next couple, just so you can see the flow. It's pretty simple. A few rounds like that and you will feel your heart rate beginning to rise as I have trying to breathe through your nose. So you're breathing, inhaling through your nose and exhaling through your nose. If you need to breathe through your mouth, that is okay. Inhaling and exhaling through your nose will build up a little bit more heat in your body and help lengthen out your breath. So it will actually help stabilize your heart rate as you move and help with that endurance aspect of the flow. So that's how you do it, and I hope that you play around with this at some point. If you have any questions, feel free to find me at the gym or reach out to me via email. I'm at martina@crossfitcypher.com. All right, have a great day, everyone. Bye.